Well, The Wild Things was the big challenge in terms of it was going to be my first picture book. And I was very feeling imperiled about doing this book because full color book, picture book form. I'd love the picture book form, but I hadn't done it yet. I'd illustrated other people's picture books, but I hadn't done my own. So it had to be a significant work, and only that it had to come thoroughly out of myself. I mean, it had to be a subject that was passionately close to my heart. So what was passionately close to my heart was a kid, and a kid doing something, and whatever that something was is what the book was going to be about. It was called Where the Wild Horses Are for a very long time, until I discovered horrifyingly that I couldn't draw horses. So I had to change the title. I changed the title various times to things that I could draw, and finally the best thing was things, because that could be anything. And so my drawing ability wouldn't be challenged by anybody. And then what do the things look like? Well, I went back into my head as to who were monsters in my life. Well, they were all my uncles and aunts. Bloodshot eyes and big, huge noses and bad teeth. And they would grab you by the cheek and pummel you and say all the conventional, banal things adults say, like how cute you are and you look so good we could eat you up. And knowing them, they probably could and would. The real problem in that book was the writing of the book and how difficult the writing of the book was. Why would a child turn a page? A child isn't polite. I mean, adults will conscientiously read a book they dislike because they feel they should. Children don't feel any such compulsion. If they hate the first two pages, swammo against the wall, that's the end of the book. They don't care if it's won 18 Caldecott Awards, right? Okay, so you've got to catch them. You've got to catch them in a kind of rhythmic pattern, in a kind of syncopation that makes them turn that page. The night Max wore his wolf's fur, and it builds, and you trap them. I mean, they can't get out of the book. That's the point of it. It was published to a lot of noise, which I'll skip. I don't think that's very interesting. Criticism and rages and carryings on that this would frighten children. Well, I knew it wouldn't, because it didn't frighten me. And I trusted myself and my own instinct, and it didn't frighten children. And if it did frighten some children, well, okay, perhaps it had to. Perhaps, I mean, why would any one book be good for all children? That's silly. I mean, no grown-up book is good for all people, so we mustn't assume that even a book that wins a Caldecott is appropriate for every child reading it. Then after Wild Things, the next picture book, In the Night Kitchen, was 1970. The reason it took the form of a comic book was because I loved comic books when I was a child. I didn't have children's books. I didn't even know there were children's books until I went to school. And we had to sit in the auditorium and hear Pinocchio read to us and Winnie the Pooh read to us. I hated them because I didn't like my teachers and I didn't like being told stories where I had to have my hands clasped in my lap. Anyway, Night Kitchen was going to be a comic book, and that was that. And it was going to be simple. It was going to look like Winsor McKay a little bit. It was going to look like Mickey Mouse a little bit. It was going to look like everybody I loved. And it was going to tell a story that obsessed me, which is a story about food, which is a story about why those little creatures at the 1939 World's Fair, those sunshine bakers with their advertisement that says, we cook while you sleep, why did they do that? Why didn't they wait till I was up? I mean, why did everything good happen when children went to bed? So this was going to be a book about a kid who gets up at night, hears what's going on, and investigates. It just feels wonderful, because it has all the energy and zest that a Mickey Mouse cartoon had for me. The action, the power, the movement, the going down, the going up, the scale of it, the logistics of it were a problem. He's in 100 different places. He goes down, he goes up, he goes across pages. So boxes and squares and oblongs and shapes had to be removed and changed to make room for him and the three bakers. So the book became a huge, I hope, beautiful garbage pail for memories past and present. And for me, a picture book that had enormous significance and far and away at that time in my life was my favorite, meant more to me than Where the Wild Things Are. It was much more contemporary in feeling. It was much more appropriate to my grown-up life.